welcome to Blog Talk. I'm Lori Duncan, a physical therapist in Colorado, and I'm very passionate about preventive physical therapy, so I'm always trying to educate everyone as much as I can. This is episode 2, and today we'll be talking about piriformis syndrome. So several years ago, I wrote a blog entitled Piriformis Syndrome. It's not about the tennis ball, because if you go look online, one of the first things you will see is everybody talking about rolling on the tennis ball and stretching, and those are the two worst things you can do for piriformis syndrome. So if you don't watch anything else, this is, you're done with Blog Talk. Do not roll on the tennis ball or an apple. I've had a patient tell me he rolled on an apple, or stretch it. It's the very worst thing you can do. Okay, so what is piriformis syndrome? I'm gonna say this as a caveat at first. If you have cleared your spine, fine, you're talking about piriformis syndrome. But if you have not cleared your spine and you are having a lot of pain in that glute and you're feeling like that's something that maybe is going on, that could be coming from your back, and you need to make sure that that is cleared, okay? So, but we're just talking about if it's just piriformis syndrome. If it's something from your back, these are treated very differently. So if somebody says that they're treated the same, they are not, okay? Let's just talk about, so if it's piriformis syndrome, let's look at this for a second. Look at this huge glute max, huge. And then after that, underneath it on the side, we call them the side glutes, are this glute med and glute min. Look at the massiveness of these glutes. Okay, so those are the guys that move your hip, not your quad. Quad moves your knee, hamstring moves your knee. The glutes are the ones that move hip, extend your hip. And they're so dysfunctional in this world, so you gotta find your glutes no matter what. But then look at this tiny little guy right here. So what happens with piriformis syndrome is that your body or your brain decides that this tiny little muscle is going to take on the load of this big guy and that other, those other two side guys. So the three good glutes go to sleep, and then this piriformis takes it on. Because what they find in research is that this, when people have this and they're going in for surgery, it's always hypertrophied, meaning it's always thickened. And if it's thickened, that means it has been used. So, and if it's used, there's a sciatic nerve, right, that runs underneath it. Now and then somebody will have it pierce into the piriformis, but that's rare. But it runs underneath it. So if it gets thick, it starts to press down on that sciatic nerve. Ow. So there's your pain. So here's the trouble, though. When people think of, you know, piriformis syndrome, they think about that symptom reliever, and they're pressing. So if you're getting a tennis ball or an apple and laying on that, what you're doing is you're cutting off the blood supply to the sciatic nerve. This is no good. Stop. And then stretching it does not really help. I use the example of somebody who's like a big bodybuilder, and he's got like huge biceps. It makes sense, I hope, that if somebody were having these huge big biceps and you wanted that to calm down, you wanted that muscle to become less developed, right, like the piriformis, that you wouldn't go and just be like, you know what, just stretch that. Let's just stretch that thing. No, you've got to take the load off of it. You'd say, don't work out your biceps anymore. So, don't work out your piriformis anymore. So don't stretch and don't roll on that tennis ball. Okay, so I also put two exercises that I find clinically that work. That doesn't mean they're the only two glute exercises. There are so many ways to wake up the glutes. So I'm gonna show you a few today. I'm gonna show you clams, I'm gonna show you fire hydrants because this has been a couple of years, and I'm gonna show you two other ones that I have found that can sometimes be pretty helpful in the clinic. But this again, if you have piriformis syndrome and you know your spine is okay, I can't emphasize that enough. So many people think that that's all that they have. And the biggest thing I tell people is piriformis syndrome is painful, but it does not make you not want to get up from the floor. So if you've ever had those episodes where you're like laying on the floor and you're like, and you just think it's that, it is almost likely coming from your spine. So get that checked out. Okay, so let's go through this real quick. Clams, right? You want to make sure your shoulders, your hips, and your heels are in one long line, and you've got to draw the belly in and stack your hips. And then you can just lift up and down. For some people, it feels better to lift your heels off. Great. This is for your side glute. All right. The other one, fire hydrants. Get yourself into a nice tabletop. The leg goes out and slightly back. You're not shifting off to the side. All right. Here's another one that I have found for people to just find their back glute. your heels together, and then you just want to think about squeezing your glutes. A lot of you will probably be in your hamstring at first, but you try to get into those good glutes. How do you know you're not using your piriformis? It won't hurt. It won't hurt. So just squeeze your glutes. Another side one that sometimes can work is from Pilates. I'll scooch this way so you can see it a little bit better. So your torso, your shoulders and your hips are in line, and then the legs are a little bit forward. So here they are in one long line, a little forward. And just making some circles. Sometimes, or leg lifts up and down. Sometimes those can be helpful. So you can play around with that. There is no one way. I mean, I'm always trying to figure out ways to wake up the system and get my patients to feel what the good glutes are. So it won't hurt. When you really find the good glutes, you'll feel them fatigue and maybe shake, and they should. That shake is not anything to be afraid of. That's actually a conversation that's happening between your brain and your new muscle that you're finding. But what you should start to feel is that the pain starts to go down as in the piriformis as you start to feel that muscle more. So you're kind of reversing this around. All right. Thank you so much for watching Blog Talk. If you have any more questions, reach out to me, but hopefully this answered a lot that I get through email. Have a great day.